Have you ever wondered what would happen to your cell phone if you came in contact with high voltage? Probably not, but my friend who's a lineman told me that when he's bringing the helicopter up to the same voltage potential as the line that he's going to work on, that his cell phone does some crazy things. I don't know how true this is, because my friend's a real character. I guess you have to be to work in that field. I think he's pulling my leg, but I figured I would take him serious and try it anyway, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'll be using a 15,000 volt transformer. Now I know for certain that high voltage interferes with electronics to some degree, and I'm not in the business of destroying cell phones, but this particular cell phone, the charging port doesn't work, the battery's puffed, it has a couple other issues, and it's basically no good. Experiments are the core definition of science, and for this first experiment, I'm just gonna create a nice arc and get it in front of the screen, see if it causes any interference with the phone, and then I'm gonna kinda go a little closer and see if I can get the arc to go inside the screen or somehow make some type of connection in there. Who knows what happened? For this next experiment, I'm going to create the arc and then bring the phone right in between the arc and see if I could get the voltage to go in or through the phone. I'm not really sure how well this is gonna work because the glass is a really good insulator and so is the plastic and rubber, but let's give it a shot and see what happens. Oh, kinda burned it there a little bit. Didn't do much. Well, that was cool, I guess. All right, here goes the next little crazy test. I sprayed the screen with some water, and I'm just gonna turn on the high voltage and let's see what we can do. Let me just get in a good position here where I'm not gonna get shocked. Hit the voltage, please. Oh, that sucker hurt my finger. Kind of burned my finger a little bit. This is why you never try this stuff at home. But this time I'm going to put one cable in position and I'm just going to hold the other cable. Hit it. I'll finish with that one and on to the next experiment, which is gonna be one wire into the headphone jack, one wire on the USB port. Hit it. Thank you. That was from the USB port to the headphone jack. I held it as long as possible. The phone even started on fire. And at first nothing was happening, but then after a little while, the video got minimized. The video is still playing and all this stuff is open, but the home button doesn't work anymore and the back button doesn't work anymore. And this button, oh wait, this one still works, okay. So yeah, that's it for all the experiments. I'm surprised that this phone made it through all of that abuse. I mean, but then again, I have seen people's phones that are not abused this bad that are in worse condition than this one. At this point, I'm convinced that my friend was totally messing with me. He's probably gonna laugh his butt off once he sees that I made this video. I couldn't believe how much voltage I put through that cell phone, and the cell phone is still functioning. And this video had been on my computer for about 8 months. Originally, I wasn't gonna post it, but in our current situation, I figured everybody could use a good laugh. So I hope you enjoyed it. Tell me what you think in the comments below, and not to worry, tomorrow I start editing the first episode of the Kohler Diesel series, so look out for that. Should be out in a couple of days. Everybody's been asking about that. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
April, look at your face. Look at that face, April, that face.